Hello, welcome to my stream today. I'll be playing Yooka-Laylee today. It's a little different from my usual shtick of doing older games or things that you might never have heard of and that I certainly sometimes have never heard of. This is because it was my birthday yesterday and I got a brand new shiny PS4. It's the slim model and it's quite svelte sitting in my cabinet over there. Since the PS4 can do streaming directly to Twitch natively, I decided to test it out. So I'm playing Yooka-Laylee, which I backed, a couple of years ago. And I was playing it quite a bit yesterday, and it's a lot of fun. So since it's my birthday, little break from tradition, we're going to play a brand new game that's fun and awesome. And yeah, that's it. Let's get started. So this is how far I've got so far. 3.5 hours in one day. Okay, that's a little... okay, that's fine. yeah, let's go in and see where we're up to. Speak up a bit. Okay, Flitch, no worries. thanks for the feedback. I did a little test just now and was getting feedback on audio levels from my compatriots here. Unfortunately, there will be a little bit of washing machine noise for the next few minutes, but I'm sure you'll get over it. There you go, shut the door. Not as much background noise. That might help matters. Yeah, there were quite a few little audio glitches and weird things going on, so hopefully we're all good now. Yeah. I did also have a little problem with the audio being marked as copyright infringing or whatever it is on Twitch, on a test stream that I did. But yeah, I don't know. It didn't happen again when I tested again, and hopefully if I've turned the volume down a little, sorry, I'm speaking louder because my washing machine is going off. Yeah, now that I've turned the volume down, maybe there won't be as much of a problem with that. Yeah, so what are we going to do? I unlocked Yooka-Laylee Glacier, which is World 2. And then I immediately left after getting a pagey or two to get Trouser's next free move from the next area. But I didn't get to the next world yet. Should I go back to Yooka-Laylee Glacier and continue there, or try and push ahead to World 3? Kind of want to get as many moves as possible, but I'm quite low on quills at the moment since I bought both of Trouser's moves in World 2 before leaving. I don't even know where to go next. I don't have the move to grapple onto those yet. yes. Flitches. Asking me about my opinions on the game so far, because he's been a bit down on the game, and also actively noting all the negative reviews that it's gotten. Apparently, critics have many criticisms, as they do, it's their job. But yeah, I'm on Gibbon's side here. I don't really care what's been said in any other reviews, just whether I like the game or not. And in fact, I do like it. I like it a lot. It feels really good to play. It's a lot like Banjo, but they've improved it. The graphics are a lot better, you know. I think exploring the worlds is a lot more fun than in other Banjo games. But yeah, as I said yesterday in the Discord, the most important thing is it makes me feel like a kid again, and it makes me smile, so I'm really happy with the game, and I will continue to play it until it's finished. Okay, these guys, I was having tons of trouble with them, but I think I figured out that if I sonar them, then I can attack them easily. Yeah. There we go, okay. I often forget to use the sonar move, but it's very helpful in this circumstance. Okay. So I think if they're glowing, I just can't hit them. Yeah, Gibbon's saying that with this game, they fixed a lot of issues that he had with Move Glut in Tui. So a lot of us are treating this game as a direct successor to the Banjo games and a design progression from them, which is perfectly reasonable. Oh, hang on. I looked at this conveyor belt before, but I'm just noticing that, yeah, it starts as a pile of wood, it gets turned into some paper, and then another stomper turns it into, what, pamphlets or books? Oh, it's like loose leaf bound books, and then the last one puts a cover on it. That's really cool. Yeah, the story of this game, if you don't know, if you're tuning in here and you have no idea what Yooka-Laylee is, it's a kickstarted game by former Rare employees who worked on Banjo games and other Rare output that, I don't know where to go for World 3, so I'm going to go to World 2. That, yeah, it was kickstarted, it met all its stretch goals, they did a good job working on the game, and it came out in reasonable time with all the features they promised, and it's basically another Banjo game, but more modern and stuff. I don't know what else to say about it. It's fun. Okay, Flitch is giving me a few hints about world stuff. Instead of... Yeah. Okay, so this is the shortcut back to Tribal Stack. And that's all that was, yeah. There's like, you open up quick ways through the hub instead of warps, which is, you know, that's a decision. Yeah, I'll look around a bit for World 3 right now. And if I can't find it, then I will request a hint from you, Flitch. You've been good about offering help to people and respecting their wishes if they don't want help. So yeah, that's good. Yeah, so Gibbon's talking about... Oh, did I not have enough speed up? Gibbon's talking about comparing this game to Tui and... oh gosh. Messages. Hang on. Hold on a second. Got a text message. I'll be right back. Yeah, the inepts. They always seem to get me when I think I've escaped them. Oops. Yeah, I like that. Yes, got a glaze glacier. Must be a little further than this. Yeah, I can. They are called inepts. That is true. These enemies here that look like a Kinect sensor. It's not a coincidence. You can prove it by. There you go, defeat 10 inept enemies to unlock this tonic. I've got a bit of a family issue to deal with, so I'm gonna have to actually call the stream ended here. I might start again in about 20 minutes or so, but I have to attend to something right now. Sorry. We didn't really start properly, did we? Just a bit of a preamble, really. Yeah, maybe I'll stitch this together with something else. Oh no, it's fine. Just my wife's a little sick, that's all. I gotta go help her out at work. Okay, how do I stop this? Buttons. Okay. Yeah, thanks for showing up. Sorry I had to stop, but I will try and start again in a bit, and I'll let you know. Okay, bye bye. Continue. Back, everything's back to normal. I tweeted. Should be good. Alright, so as you can see, I've selected the Hunter tonic. I haven't had it actually work yet, so I don't know what it really does. My favorite so far is roll move using less power, but yeah. I'll try and unlock more as I go on. Okay, so that's a shortcut. So, reminder, currently I am looking for the World 3 entrance. So, Glitterglaze is here. It wasn't through the archive, was it? I think I've been up the slope at the end of that corridor and it's just, Ah. Yeah. PS4 streaming has an overlay on the top right corner. I think it will show up in stream archives too. But it tells you. It pops up whenever a new person is watching or whenever someone makes a comment. And I don't know if I really like that to be there all the time. Ooh, watch out. This is. Damn. Energy. Ah, now look at Capital B's quote here. Big Fang's obsessed with crystals. I'm convinced that this is a reference to Croc, Legend of the Gobos, and I love that game, so that makes me happy. See some butterflies and low on health. Yeah, given saying he's used four pretty much the whole time. It seems like the best thing just to get around, since rolling is fast and fun. Okay, so that's Rexro's arcade in there. This seems like a logical place to go to for the next area. Since Trouser was in here and he gave me the water bubble move. Yeah. So either I want to use Baller as much as I can or get more of those energy upgrades. I had. Alright, the waterway. The waterworks. I found one in Glitterglaze Glacier, but none others so far. Yeah, it must be here. I just haven't explored this place very much yet. I'm trying to cheese my way up the geometry right now, but instead of doing it the intended way. I did a challenge down in the bottom here. Let's do a little thing, because I know one of Bendy's tokens is. The requirement is to kill underwater enemies. So I'll just do that a little bit. I don't think the way forward was through here. I found another shortcut in here, actually. Back to the first area of Highway Towers. Oops, wrong button. When I found out that you could hold down the sonar button and get rapid fire, I was. Double the number of collectibles, gosh. That's already enough. Bubbles are pretty cool power up. It means that you don't have to deal with the swimming controls, which not bad actually, but Ooh, okay. That looks quite likely. Ah! I can't attack unless I'm in a bubble form, but that's okay. You know, I wish when you were low on health it would actually show up on screen. Banjo used to do that. Maybe it does and I just... I'm talking about. Butterflies. Good stuff. Okay. So what is this world? There were some scary pumpkins. Oh, hello. Get past the next door. yes. Oh, we're here already. Okay, that was easy. I'll explore a little bit first. Looks a little swampy. Swamp world, perhaps. That was easy. Oh, he doesn't want to come with me. Country kick. Oh wow, okay, this is different. I was just about to call myself out for referring to that page as he, but then I think you did the same thing. I know where I'm going. Oh! Cool. Crazy Kirko. Not drinking water. Have to remember to check the emulator. So... H2O only. Does that mean that Pagey was named Crazy Kirko? Wouldn't be the first time that... You know, Rare employees have put their name in the game. As a character. Greg the Grim Reaper comes to mind, although that was a reference to Greg, it wasn't him putting it in himself. Well, I'm sure Grant wasn't behind naming that Pagey. Mumbling, rambling. Let's go back up to the world now, if I can remember how to get up there. It was down through an underwater grating or something. Oh, it's the same. Guess I'll have to go under. Okay, pretty sure I went from the cage this way. And then... What's it here? No. Hey, hey! Good to see you, Wolf. I'm just getting to World 3. So, welcome. I have heard on the chat that World 3 is the worst world, but we'll see. How are you doing? I just got this game yesterday and I've played 3.5 hours now. You'll need 7 of us. I have those. Yes. Moodymaze Marsh. What is that symbol? I keep forgetting to really look at the symbols on the front of the books. It was, I think it was a snowflake for the last world. And I'm not expanding them. I am going through worlds in their basic forms first. Before I expand them. Oh, hey Courtney, welcome. Yeah, I am trying not to get too influenced by other people's thoughts on the content, so I acknowledge that people have said it's the worst, but Gibbon's also now saying it's the best. But yeah, I will form my own opinions, don't worry. Yeah, Mitch says it's the worst, but not that's not like a glaring indictment, it's just slightly worse than the other ones. Okay, Courtney's saying the thing on the cover was a purple tentacle. It did kind of remind me of that Day of the Tentacle thing. The tentacle, you know, from the Day of the Tentacle. Ow! Ah! So bad water? There's no little piranhas that pop up that tell you though. That sucks. There's no sand eels in this game. Too bad. Alright. Yeah, let's use bubble. Swimming is annoying. Alright. So my first priority is finding Trouser, although I don't think I'll be able to afford any of his moods yet. They're up to 40... 40 quills in Glacier. Whoa, what are these? Little swamp monsters. I like the little minions in each level. How they're themed. They're really cute too. Random pipes, okay. I see grapple. I think grappling is something I'm gonna have to invest in soon. But he might have other tempting moves, that Trouser. Yeah, seems like a missed opportunity not to have piranhas in there. I like that.
Piece of paper got caught in trap over there. Trap activated by sound of splashing. So lizard keep feet dry.
They didn't answer the question on the agenda. Alright. Let's try it. That was easy. Hooray! Easy challenges. Yeah, the music is nice and sort of atmospheric in this level. I'm always, of course, tempted to say, oh, I wonder if this was Coco Ball-wise, but, yeah, I don't wanna... Maybe I'll just say it doesn't matter and that it just sounds good. For now. I love Trouser. That kind of shunky salesman type. Oh, it's just features. Heads haven't caught up with you yet, then.
I've been thinking about launching a Trouser patented drone delivery business. New moves delivered right to your doorstep. Along with an expert instruction video by myself. What do you think?
I wouldn't trust you to deliver my takeaway.
Super! Great to have your support. Now why don't you have a look at what's in stock?
Yes, I've got all the moves so far. Wizard Lash, Sonar Explosion. Ah, Breaking Glass. 2% off. Yeah. Both of them sound useful, but I'd probably go for the... the grapple one first, because movement tech is my preferred thing, I think. Oh, Wolf, I'm playing on PS4. I just got a brand new PS4 yesterday for my birthday, and so I'm testing the native streaming functionality on it. Apart from a few audio kinks, it seems to be working pretty well, so that's good. Oh wow, so David Wise only did the Kartos music in the whole game, that's it? Didn't he do the tribal challenge or something? Or is that what that is? I haven't found Kartos yet, by the way, except in Rextro's minigame. And Steve Burke only did Rextro's music. This is interesting information. Is this a shopping trolley?
Another sad day in the swamp for Ollie, discarded and unloved.
Alright, Oils, got any pages in your pile of rubbish there?
So, the only thing you'll find in my basket is heartbreak and despair.
is swamp trash as well. I can see it. What can you tell us about this maze thing ahead, Ollie?
So, it's horrible. Winding and endless. And to make things worse, the walls move to stop trespassers from grabbing the pagey at the end. So, you're still interested, I suppose?
Sure. It doesn't sound as bad as some of the challenges we've done so far. We'll give it a go.
So, good luck. Sadly, there's no light at the end of the maze for poor Ollie.
Oh, he did do some other tracks, like the boss music in this world. Okay, good to know. Yeah. Yeah, like Courtney, I didn't want to look into the soundtrack too much until I'd experience it in context. Oh, well, the camera's really tricky in this section. Oh, nope. That's not the way. What? Is this a maze or just an impenetrable clump? Maybe there's a way to destroy this somehow. At least be slightly cheesy and just go around the outside. Okay. I haven't seen a pagey. Nah, Wolf's checking himself for attribution mistakes. Going to look at the soundtrack. Whoopsie! This isn't bad yep, bad water. Help! Get me out. Oh man. Okay. Very low on health. Gotta find some random butterflies. There's one. Not random, but. Crates! I don't know if you can see my trophy notifications, but I just got one for getting quills or something. Does that mean I got a milestone quill amount? 200. Pretty cool. So, an haunted evil swamp. That has actually been done before in Banjo games. We had the sort of chaotic neutral swamp in Bubble Gloop. But Bad Magic Bayou in Grunty's Revenge, the game that nobody likes to talk about, had exactly this. It was like a voodoo, evil swamp. There was, you know, the marsh area with boardwalks and stuff, and then separate from the main area was a haunted mansion kind of thing. But yeah, American style, I think. Yeah, Grunty's Revenge is good. This isn't exactly a haunted swamp, just a creepy swamp then, I guess? There are those evil pumpkin jack-o'-lantern things. So Vinny had something new for me. What was it? Bruiser? Ooh, that's pretty good. I haven't had Hunter actually activate yet, so I don't really know what it's supposed to do. I might leave it on just to find out how effective it is. But yeah, extra health from butterflies might be good, but I wish I had a bit more health in general. I found one health upgrade in the hub world, and one energy upgrade in Glitterglaze Glacier. Sup, Liz man? Wally's the name. Are you the owner of this mushroom patch? Hi, Wally. It's not ours. We're in the pagey business ourselves. Sweet, keep it that way. This level's my turf. I grow the tasty shrooms around here for my farmer's market stall. I love farmer's markets. The high prices keep the riffraff out. Too right. Say, could you two help me out destroying the shroom patch? I totally own it, and I'm sure I saw some gold bling inside one of them shrooms. Gold bling sounds good to us. We'll give it a go. I'm struggling on Yooka's voice. I don't know. Laylee was like a cockney. I've lost it. Oh well, let's just get through this. All down at once, huh? I don't need the sonar screen for that, do I? Okay, go, 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 go. Oh. Okay. Yep, they start popping up again. Did I bounce off that one for a reason? Yeah, a swamp with some very light, spooky theming. So, Courtney's telling me that, the secret hunter thing makes items whistle at me. Haven't noticed that so far, but I will listen out for the whistling. Wolf's still looking for a list of tracks and who composed them. Kind of hard to find, apparently. Apart from the pumpkins, says Gibbon, it's more of a trash swamp with the trolley NPCs in the sewage pipes. I see some fire coming out there. That's a trademark spooky swamp move. Will-o-wisps and such. Ah, the eyeballs. What a great idea. Oh. Ow. They're tough, those eyeball enemies. yeah. Like a cat call. Okay. So it will activate when... it'll start whistling for quills when there's only a few left on the level. That's good. That's useful. As long as you've got stereo sound on. And who doesn't these days? I like the camera. I'm finding it actually works really well. Having a stick. Very modern. Spooky garbage swamp. Yeah, having a swamp just filled with rubbish is, I guess, a bit more true to life. Less natural, urban kind of thing. But that's kind of a theme in this game, how the Ivory Towers factory, you know, there's pipes everywhere. Sort of like the corporate business has kind of crapped all over the environment and stuff, but good stuff, Pagey. Now, have I come out in a new area? Yes. I wasn't finished back over there though. I wonder, should I go back or nah? It's actually moments like this when there's a few things you've noticed you can do and you're just sort of tallying up a little mental checklist of places to go and things to check out. When the game reminds me most of Donkey Kong 64, but I'm doing it in a better way than that game did. I did enjoy Donkey Kong 64 a lot, but it's not good. Not a really good game. But yeah, I mean, Tui was like that too, but for some reason I find that more tedious, even though the actual challenges in Tui are a lot more well put together than the DK64 ones. Alright, let's see what we're doing here. Ah, I see. Okay, got it. Nope. Oh, this is really tricky. Okay. As long as it's, getting it to the end and then moving, it's a bit easier than getting it into a slot like that. Ha! good.
No worries.
Just checking for secret hidden stuff. I know there's a thing called pirate treasure. I haven't found any of it yet. I assume it's hidden pretty well. Yeah, so Wise did all the Kartos songs, says Mitch. Still haven't met Kartos. Do I need to expand to meet him? I haven't expanded at all yet. Eat it. I didn't need it. I don't really use the roll, actually, unless I know an area already and I want to get through it quicker. What's this? We need the grapple for that. Ah, now have I just joined up with where I was before? No, I don't think so. I actually kind of enjoy getting lost in these worlds. Trying to find my way around and discovering secrets. That's what it's all about. That's the core gameplay. And it's great. Every world theme is Kirkhope. Every Rextro song is Burke. Main theme is Kirkhope, end theme is Wise. But Mitch can't figure out the boss theme, she says. Oh, I felt something, and I heard a whistle. I mean, I felt a rumble. Also, I hear the giggling of a ghost rider. Must be in this groove somewhere. Yep, Courtney heard it too. Open shortcuts when I see them. I hope that's a shortcut. Yes, it is. Good. Let's check it out. Yeah, so the pipe I saw is actually useful. Cool. This game's really good. Okay. I feel like I walked past the ghost rider and they're back here somewhere.
There we go.
Cool. Gotta say, I really like that jingle too. It's like a spooky little melody, but then it turns into a nice jingle. But I'm still hearing whistling. Yeah, it's still there. Is it coming from up there somewhere? Oh, well, let's keep going at ground level for now. So what's this? Okay, this is just where I came down into that pond. No, I came up out of that pond. Have I been in here? Yes, okay. So let's go this way. Logs. I'm gonna go back. Oh, what's that? How do I get up there? Not sure if that's intended. That's not. I'm supposed to pull that box away to get up here. But yeah, it looks like you're expected to know the grapple. I'll just leave that quill so I know for sure that I haven't been here when I look. Nah, screw it. I need quills. Get the one I can, at least. 72. How many did I need for that one trouser move? It was less than 72. It was 60, right? Let's take the pipe back to the start. Yeah. Where's the pipe? It was over here. The ghosts are adorable, says Gimme. Totally agreed. Let's have a look. Yeah. I haven't found any of the red ones yet. I got 4 of the 5 in Tribal Stack. And I was only in Glitter Glaze for a brief time, so I didn't get barely any there. Don't think I got any. Nope, don't get distracted. Let's go find Trouser. And then I can finally grapple. No. Yeah. I haven't even seen any glass yet, except for a little bit in the hub. Yes, I tell you, yes! 3 consecutive Sales Snake of the Year awards. How does a moo win you a sales award? Unless it's rubbish and you manage to shift it. They must have recognized my meticulous technique. Ridiculous physique, more like. Laylee, go on, Trouser. What do you have for us? With Lizard Lash, our lizard friend will be able to attach to special grapple points by facing towards them and pressing circle. You could launch across gaps attached to things and etc. that I didn't read. Sounds great. We'll come back if we need a reminder. He's now an Oka Aussie, apparently. Yeah, I'll hurry back. Okay, so when it's glowing, I can. Camera. Oh, that's awesome. I love that. Okay. See another adorable ghostie. And this one is red. Oh, bollocks. Haven't seen a red one before. So these ones you have to fight, right? Like a ninja. Yeah, take that. Okay, so do I have to wait for it to charge and then attack while it's orange? That looks like it. Ow! So it has to miss. Ow! You jerk. Yeah, take that. Oops. So the Ghost Riders are the spirits of dead authors of the Grand Tomes, right? Did they all collaborate on the Grand Tomes, or did they write one each? That's my question. Please answer it. Please answer it now. Okay. Cool, so now we're on another layer above the ground floor, and you can get to different places. I like that. That's like level design or something. Speaking of which, where the heck am I? Okay, so I've been there. I do like that you can cheese your way up certain things where you're not supposed to be. It's very freeing as a player. Gimmon posted a thread about that on the DK Vine forum. I will check it out if I'm curious later on people's thoughts. So that's where Ollie was, right? What was the bling shopping trolley's name? I think I've done everything in this area for now. Unless these mushrooms are super ugly and I love it. What's that? Ah, it's a glowing mushroom. Okay. Let's go over here. Ollie and Wally is what I've seen so far. Wow, so high up. This is amazing. Wolf saying he wants to say that there's one author for each book because there are five of each of those things. One, five ghostwriters, five books. But what do I do with these pumpkins? Can I grapple the pumpkins? Ow! That was bad. No, I can't grapple the pumpkins. Maybe I can jump out to each one. Oh! No, that's not good. Yes, but to finish Wolf's comment, why would the other four writers appear in the fifth author's work? So why isn't there just one in each? Well, you do find, like, Kartos, Rextro, Clara, Trouser, Vendi in each world as well. Whether that's a result of Capital B's meddling with the Grand Tames or not, I'm not sure, but if other characters can appear in each one, and if the ghostwriters do have some kind of mystical, power over these tome worlds, then them crossing between them is not such a big stretch. But Wolf is leaning towards them collaborating on each of the books. Given saying the levels really open up when you expand them. Yeah, I assume that what I'm seeing is but a fraction of the total that will be available to me later. Courtney hasn't had time to get her head kind of straight on this game. Alright, let's go find that one area that I was looking at before with the logs, but I didn't go through. Did I have to go through a pool of water to get there, or can I go over the top? And if so, can I remember where either of those things are? Well, here's the pool, so... This doesn't take energy, does it? Maybe it does. Ah. I'll just swim it. Yes, the five collaborating isn't traditionally how books work. Well, authors collaborate in books. I just finished reading the Empire Trilogy, which is a collaboration between Jenny Wirtz and Raymond E. Feist. They work together on it. Some interesting chat going on here, so I do want to address that. So Courtney's saying the books are portals to real places, right? To which Gibbon responds that we're secretly in Denis, or Dunny, as I like to call it, which is the place in Mist where Atrus is imprisoned. Although I think he lived there before the events of the game, right? Yeah, writing the books creates a portal to a matching world, drawing that parallel there. And so maybe they're a team that wrote non-fiction books about the places, says Courtney. World 4 doesn't make sense to be a fictional place, says Wolf. But I haven't been to World 4 yet, so cannot speak to that. Oh, chat's going wild about this stuff. The pages come from a book that can rewrite reality. I'm assuming that grand tomes represent real worlds that were created through being written into existence, which explains the various NPCs moving between books. Possible that World 4 was something else, but Capital B rewrote it to be in his image. Yeah, this is fascinating. Where, making new laws live here. Or, trying to figure it out between us. It's really fun. I hear the whistle. I hear it. Yes! That was it. That was the whistle, I'm sure. Rextro's plate coin for this world. Good. Hooray! Pagey! Yay! Tilted head. Tilted head dance. Tilted head dance. Tilted head dance.
Yes, the combination of quills and pages are what Mitch assumes are needed to rewrite tomes. Makes sense. Maybe in the sequel, Trouser rewrites the tomes in his image because he has all the quills you gave him, says Wolf.
Whereas Gibbon is sad that this lore is happening in the chat and not being put written down on the forum, which I can agree with, because nobody's replied to the Ghost Riders topic. Oh well. I always wonder if things like this will be filled in once I populate the world. Or expand the world, I should say. See those butterflies down there? They're not moving. Oh, now one's moving. What are they doing? Why does one stop moving? I thought it was a draw distance thing. Yeah, it is. I thought maybe one landed somewhere and stopped, but no. I think it's they stop being animated when they're far enough away. Yeah, funny.
Okay, cool.
Alright, now I was looking for those logs. And I know I came out of this pool. And then I found them somewhere. There they are. Cool. Wolf lamenting the state of the forums. It's too bad. I've been off the forums for a while, so. Yeah. Don't really know what's going on there. But it's a real shame if these kinds of discussions aren't happening there, because that's what the forum's all about. That's what it should be about. But really, if it's what the people are into, the people will do it where they want, I guess. And we're doing it here instead of on the ground. I don't know. I don't have any conclusions, I'm just rambling. But yeah, I don't know. I mean, the forum is a good place and something to be celebrated, but sometimes the format just isn't for everyone. Sometimes, you know, sometimes it gets nasty there. So you just don't want to deal with that. I don't know. Oh, what's this? There's fire. How do I make fire go? To burn the rope. Ice? Eat ice? No, can't do that. Fire berry, breathe fire into there. Need fire berry. Cannot see one. We'll come back later.
Yeah, blog post could work. I think I'm subscribed to your blog. No, that's someone else's. I'll try and find yours.
Gibbon's unemployed, so he has time to transcribe our lore workshopping onto the forum. And Courtney and Wolf are commiserating on lack of time and inclination to be on the forum. Another trolley. Hey there, is everything in order? It's a bit whiffy around here. Oh wait, that's on voice.
The name's Jolly. I'm in charge of keeping the water here clean and fresh.
How do you still have a job?
Well, nobody's noticed the machinery messed up while I was holidaying in Capital Casino. What a weekend that was, by the way.
Yeah, yeah, get to the bit where we help you.
I need to get all the switches up there pressed to restart the water filter. Clean water, that will help a lot in this world. My wheels ain't what they used to be. Can you help me out with the switches? You'll need to start with the one next to me here. We'll help you out, Jolly. Great stuff. I've got this bit of paper I fished out of the clog pipe you can have as a reward. There's some other stuff stuck to it too. You can take that. Thanks. poop jokes. Excellent. Okay, start with the switch, huh? But I can't. It's blocked. Oh. Nice. Okay. Jolly? Oh wait, Jolly? Looks a bit different to Jolly Roger. I detect some eyelashes, so it's possible that they're coded as female. But that just might be a common feature to these trolleys that I haven't noticed. What is medium wolf? Can you explain that? He's suggesting Courtney make a medium page for what? Rare metaphysics discussions and Paper Mario character analysis. You know what? I would read that. Hey, screw you, buddy. Whoops, I'm running out of time here. Quick, quick, quick. Haha, I didn't need that thing. Ah, oh, so close. I was killing these bees, so don't bother me. Hey! What gives? Ow, the explosion hurt me. I don't like that. Ow, no. Okay, this is tricky. I am going to try and kill these bees before I do this.
Oh man, so much chat. A new platform. It's a service to host writing and make it easier for other people to find your writing. It's a Tumblr-esque web community that's focused on written work.
Okay. That's interesting. I started using Tumblr for game reviews, but then I also used it for pixel art and comic translations. Medium sounds interesting, but maybe just for my reviews, perhaps. But if it wouldn't be able to handle my other projects, then I don't think I could switch over to it entirely. Or keep both running at once, so, yeah. Also, I don't know. Maybe the people who like my pixel art comics on Tumblr would appreciate me moving all the review stuff off it, because they probably don't care about that as much. But that's why I started the damn thing. Yeah, that's right. We start in the middle platform up here. Okay.
Interesting.
Wolf likes the fonts and stuff that they use on Medium. It makes every dumb thing he publishes, he says, look professional. Whoops. Oh man, I should stop reading chat in the middle of platforming challenges. Okay. Don't even need the grapples, dude. Don't even need them. That's probably quicker. Oh no, grapple's pretty quick. The grappling is a quick process. Alright, I've just opened up a whole world of underwater stuff. I don't know how I feel about that.
Bags a dozen, fellas. As promised, here's that bit of paper from the clog pipe. You might want to use gloves to handle it.
Gorgeous. Oh, did you lose some chat? Just talking a little about Medium. Wolf was explaining what Medium is and why he thinks it makes his writings look professional, because they
the formatting and stuff is good. Alright, let's skip underwater and head over here first. Ooh, I see an arcade cabinet. I didn't actually take that many tries to get the tribal strike tropics, both pages, you know, including the high score one. But first, let's get distracted. Every little thing. It's fun. I love it. Yeah, I'm guessing that's gonna lead somewhere in the expanded world. So this section of water is still gross. Murky. Kind of a subtle difference between the two. I heard that. Must be underwater. I will not get that yet. Oh, Puzz, hello. Oh, I don't have the molly tool. Okay, see you later. I like Puzz's character design. But, like, she seems to be human who was accidentally transformed. Yeah, she's in it. Humans are fairly rare in these games, so that's interesting. But hey, you don't know that. She might have started as an octopus and accidentally halfway transformed herself into a weird humanoid thing. There you go, new headcanon for Dr. Puzz. I've already met you, X-Tray. Yes. Love it. Okay.
Yes, I want to play Bebop.
Now, I have played all these mini games before because I was visiting family last weekend, and I played, so my brother had Yooka-Laylee on the PC, and he was just showing me a little bit of it, and then we played all the mini games in multiplayer mode, and it was actually very fun and exciting. I recommend it. Nice little party game stuff. But yeah, the upshot of that is that I know the basics of all these mini games, which is good. Ouch. Come on. Okay, I can just run into them now. Oh, I ran out already. Come on. What is my goal here exactly? High score, I think, in the time game. Wonder what the target is for the second page. What's the target for the first page? So, as Wolf informed us earlier, this piece of music is a Steve Burke number. Come on. I've been hit a few times by these guys, but have I actually lost any health? Maybe only the fire makes you lose health. Nah, I ran out of energy. Nuts. That wasn't good at those. Ah, it runs out so quick. It's totally screwed me over. Whew. Rextro!
One of the best, huh? Zing! Yeah, blocks. He mentioned memory cards. Last time I talked to him. Cool. Yes, I do. High scores, please. What are they? What are the high scores? What do I need to get? Oh, it shows me here. Maybe? Yes? Radical drones! Boost area attack. Oh, boost! I didn't know about the boost. Okay, I'll do that. 4,000, oh gosh. Now look at these names, and you can sort of guess what some of them are. ADY, Andy Robinson, CST, Chris Sutherland probably, ADM, I don't know. Okay, I don't know any others. Never mind. Okay, so Gibbon made the post about the lore on the forums, but he says feel free to still do other posts about it elsewhere. Can you summarize it for us, Gibbon? Oh, boost. No. I was already doing that. That's just like the go up jumping thing. Okay, I knew about that. Never mind. I wouldn't have called that a boost, so I guess that's what it is. Close enough. Ah. Yes, okay, good. What is the best way to get lots of points? I guess hit all the minions. What's our consensus on that lore? The books were written by the Ghost Riders. Possibly collaboratively, or they just have the power to travel between them. The Grand Tome fits into that all somehow. Oh man, I'm all vague, even though we talked all about it. I don't know if we made any conclusions. We definitely said the quills and pages together were important somehow. Ah, that guy's like slightly in the background, I can't get him. Seems unfair. Ah, yes, okay. I've already got my high score, so that's good. Ah, out of engine. Okay, see you, Courtney. Good to see you. Here. Yeah, thanks for showing up. Cool. You. So the first time you get a high score, Rextro is like, oh, here, write your name on this piece of paper. Like an amusing three-letter name. But then I guess when you do get a high score, it just says you. Yeah, I don't know how you would lose. Maybe by losing all your health. But I'm sure I got hit a few times and it didn't seem to have lost any health. More memory jokes, yeah. Good. Yay, more pagey. No thanks, Rustro. That was cool. Alright, let's explore the water. Go! Okay, that's something. What is that? What's that? An egg? Oh, it's a molecule, I think. How do we get in there? Go up. Oh, okay. Mitchell says you is possibly Yooka's idea of a joke. That's actually a good idea. I didn't think of that, but yeah. I buy that, actually. Oh man, was that a fish? No, it was a quill inside a pipe that I saw. I guess we'll check out the pipe. Yooka is a dad joke, so. Swampy Station. Don't tell me there's trains in this game. That's right, he doesn't have a name to put in there because he tells you to write it on a pagey and then you take the pagey. Ah, whoa, golly. You probably don't have to stun them if they just shot a thing, because then their red spiky jobbies aren't poking out. I think that's what hurts you when you try to get close to them. Yeah, thanks for doing that, Gibbon. Hopefully it generates some discussion. That's so much. Aha, sonar. Need the sonar. Looks like I probably can't do much else without it. Ooh, except I can do this. It's going to be hard to catch this one, though, because movement is a little tricky underwater. It's a bit slippery and slow. Oh. Is there another way to make him slow down or make it? There we go. Yeah, that worked. If you attack while moving forwards in the air, you get like a forward boost thing. So that helped me in that situation. Aha, what's this? Berries. Grenade berries? This is so banjo. Oh yeah, I didn't read that out earlier, but Gibbon did mention that he liked how instead of having a massive wheel of eggs that you'd had to collect all the time in Tui, they're like contextual and you just eat the right berry in this game. And I must agree. Okay, quickly make some eggs. Cool. That one. Okay. So, no reward for killing all those bees, but that's okay. I wonder if the grenade will break the glass. Because if it doesn't, that's kind of BS. My spines didn't change colour. Usually they do when you eat a berry, right? Nope. Okay, that's fine. That's just kind of a logic gap. I guess the explosion isn't powerful enough to break glass with cracks in it. Gibbon's gonna single-handedly keep the DK line for him running. And yeah, I mean, I like the DK go to forums, but I guess forums just aren't for me at this stage of my life. I'm not going to be posting on DK Vine, then I also won't post on Gerda. Sorry. Oh, you think the spines turned a little grey with the grenade berries? Possibly. Maybe it was just the item in there was hard to do. So it seems I can ignore currents while in the bubble, which doesn't seem to make sense, but okay. Oh, speed. I can't make that. What if I stand on this and then remove bubble? Yeah, there we go. But now I'm trapped here, so was that a mistake? What do I think of the power bar, asks Mitch. Oh, spikes. Is there a way around? It's just kind of blocking. Let's go up. Yeah. I I like that at any time you can just cancel the whole animated thing by doing that. At the expense of a very small amount of power bar, which then rapidly fills back up. So, yeah. You don't really have to worry about air as much in this game. Oops. I guess my energy's not recovering while I'm still underwater. Didn't notice that. So speaking of the energy bar, I think, well, I don't like that I can't just roll whenever I want. Oh yeah, it came back. It came back. What does this do? Does it make those bubbles go? What's the point? I mean, what is it used for? It's a way to stop you just doing whatever you want all the time. What things actually use the power bar? The bubble uses a tiny bit. The sonar uses a tiny, tiny bit. But you don't use it so constantly that you're going to suddenly find that you can't do it anymore. It means that health isn't always health, because if you pick it up from running into it instead of eating it, then it refills your energy bar instead of restoring your health. And I don't like that, because sometimes you need health and you accidentally pick up a butterfly. What does that switch do? What if I'm standing on both these switches? Oop. What did that do? Did that open that grate? Yeah, the grate's closing now, so let's get over there. Okay. Man, this is like Bat's Tower, man. You know, the underwater bit. The Bat's Tower chapter. Oh, you trying? Okay, so given so there's a lot of challenges later that are basically energy bar management. I did notice with Nimbo's challenge. Is that his name? Nimble? Nimbo? The cloud? The racing cloud. Part of that was making sure that you had enough energy during the race so that you didn't have to stop rolling, because if you just run around you're not fast enough. You need to be rolling as much as you can to stay ahead. That's what I feel. No, I didn't. That's fine. Oops, nope, wasn't quite fast enough. So it made sense for that challenge, and if there's other ones like it, then yeah. And I guess I don't have a problem with it in principle. I mean, think about it also in the terms of rolling as the replacement for talent trot. And maybe it's a good thing that you can't just do it all the time. Speaking of which, that the noise of the sonar, the noise of constant sonaring is a little bit like the talent trot noise, isn't it? Through that whole underwater obstacle course. Whoa, you're not pagey, rampagey. Getting all of these over so I can kill them. Try and get some of that progress on the Vendi challenge, killing underwater enemies. I'm guessing that tonic will just, improve my air meter or something. Ah, here we go, see? We're getting to the limit of my energy at the moment by using the sonar underwater a lot. Oh, I didn't try surfacing. Yooka seemed to do that by himself. Well, there's nothing. So we'll go through that pipe. Okay, ignore that one. Oh, I just tried to roll without realizing that I would use my bubble toggle thing. Yeah. So, in conclusion, the energy system is interesting and different, but also similar to other games, and it's fun to like upgrade it so you feel more powerful by getting the hidden energy bar extenders. And it's not like you feel like you're constantly running out of energy. It's only in extreme circumstances, or if you're overusing certain moves. So, yeah, I think the balance is good and doesn't make it feel restrictive like it did in, say, Skyward Sword. With the stamina bar. So, yeah, that's my verdict on that. And I believe I've been in the pipes. And I can hear a sound. Oh, yeah, that's the patron thing. How do I get that? Getting cut by thorns. I don't know. Maybe a move I'll get later. But I think I'm done with this area. Let's go check out the other bit beyond the pond. Wolf says, I think the only thing worth limiting is flight. Rolling sonar and bubbles only seem limited because they felt it necessary to not have a power bar for one thing. So what else does use the power bar? You say flight does, rolling, sonar, and bubbles. Yeah, bubbles, as I found down there, it wasn't really a problem that I would run out of energy from using bubbles, unless I was also using the sonar. The rolling, I think it is fine to limit the rolling by means of the energy bar. I don't have a problem with that. Because Yooka's normal running speed is fine. And it keeps you on the lookout for butterflies. Which is, you know, engaging for the player, in a way. Let's go around before going in that pack. I feel like this is a big sort of hub thing, and there's not going to be anything else behind it, really. At least maybe not until I expand. Ooh, Kartos! Interesting. Let's do Kartos.
Underwater air and flight stamina could both be tied to a stamina bar if it was that instead of energy, says Wolf. Oh yeah, there's other power-ups that they're talking about that I haven't got to yet that use energy. And, yeah... Oh, cool. You're going to be on the conversation, Wolf. That's awesome. I'll definitely listen to that since I've actually played the game now. I can start listening to the Yooka podcast episodes. Good. Yes, everyone check out the conversation whenever it comes out. Yeah, good luck. I'm sure you'll do great. You're a good podcast dude. So yeah, thanks for showing up to the stream. It was good to see you. Yeah, so, I mean, from all the things you're mentioning, Gibbon, that do use it later on, I feel like it is useful to have the energy bar if there's going to be a whole bunch of power-ups that use it. The more things that use it, the more useful it is. Who might you be?
Howdy, strangers! Name's Kartos.
let me guess. God of War?
I have no idea what y'all be lapping about, miss. My job's to rid the rails of them grand tomes. Oh, ride the rails. And bring back gold. Though I have not seen much treasure in a long time. Nobody cares for us minecart fellows no more.
Did you play Tropical Freeze? I keep losing Laylee's accent. Sorry, what did you say? I wasn't paying attention.
Nice to meet you, Kartos. We're searching for pages. Do you think we'll find any on your tracks? You'll find plenty when you're inside me, boy. There's gold in them there mine shafts. Say, how's about your critters being my partner in a ride?
Can't tell if he's Scottish or a prospector. Like a American gold rush prospector kind of thing. Lily's only joking, Carlos. Let's go for a ride.
Hoo-wee! If it's the PG I'll be after, you'll be needing to collect 125 of them gems this time. Let's go! Do you need to know the controls, critters?
Yes, please.
You'll be needing extra jump, square to fire, and the L stick to boost or break.
Wait, that break was spelled wrong. There's a few typos I've noticed in this game. Just so you know. It's not perfect. Oh! Didn't quite make that jump. And I lost gems from being hit. Dang. Ah! Forgot to shoot. Ah! Again! Ah! I might need to do this a few times. Oh! Okay. Ah! Oh! Oh, man! Okay, I needed to boost there. Ah! This is crazy! Whoa. Okay, I'm back where I was before. Okay, so boosting or breaking is like, it's not something you just do actively. You have to sort of tap to activate a boost or break maneuver. Oh. So this is David Wise music. I gotta say, actually, it does feel kind of Tropical Freeze-ish. That. Jump. I do have the soundtrack from being a backer, so I'm looking forward to listening to that in its entirety later when I've played more of the game. Darn it. This is really tough. I wonder how many there are in total, though. I might find that even though I'm having trouble, I might get enough gems by the end. Am I back on a previous section? The reaction time. Maybe I need to break more. Yeah, am I just going around in circles? When does it end? Does it end when I have enough? Curses. Nope. That's the goal. Didn't quite get 125. Okay, it ends when you get on the right track. Yes, I'll try again. Hoo-wee! Yeah, so as a replacement for collecting red feathers and gold feathers, I think the energy bar is good. Curse. Shoot it. Yes, I got it. Okay. Yeah. So I have to be good about picking the wrong multiple choice track so I can redo these bits. Try and get more gems. Okay. And be wary of the cooldowns. So the correct one would be like the middle one. As long as you're high enough, you can bounce on them. Okay, now we're back here. So the angle of Kartos is important when you shoot the cannonball. Oh, no. Got a boost for that bit. Okay. Yeah, I feel good about this. Oops. Oops. Whoops. Where am I? Okay, we're going back. Good. So not the middle one. Ah! Bloody hell. No! Okay, we're doing okay. Kind of just spits a cannibal out of his mouth. Gross. Nope. Alright, we'll try and get that again. I think I might be a little stuck though. There might not be too many gems left to find. The sound of Kartos breaking is so annoying if I'm not the one playing, says Gibbon. Damn it. Okay, boost. Yeah. How many is an orange worth? Is it five? It's quite a cooldown on those cannonballs. Oops, I picked the wrong one. Yeah, I gotta do better in the earlier sections, I think. So even when I looped a few times, I don't think I would've got enough. Yeah, he's not Scottish. He's definitely an old-timey prospector man. Whoops! Oh, gosh. Ah! Stupid cannibals. No. Okay. So I think I'm doing a little better than I was before. Ah, broke too early. Well, braked? Braked? Yeah, braked. I think. What's this? Okay. Oh, that's a failure, but there's gems there! Gosh. We're gonna crack this, guys. And gals. Well, I think Gibbon's the only one still here. Corny left, Wolf left. It's okay. I've done plenty of streams with just Gibbon. I love it. Damn it. Pow! Okay. 30 at this point is pretty good. No! No, 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 no! Ow. Can I loop back on this bit? Maybe? Is this what this is? I think this is a loop back. It is. Good. Okay, I'll do that again. Yes. Wait. I think the other bit was the loop. Okay, I missed the loop, but that's okay. I might have enough at this point. Doing pretty well on gems, so yeah, let's do this. Don't fall down there. Those troll gems. 101. 106, okay, so orange is 5. And smashing into something is a loss of 3. Whoa, what was that? Nah! Okay, I think we're good. We'll go to the end after this. There isn't like a second Kartos challenge, is there? To get a greater number of gems? Given you've played this game. Is there a second layer of challenging? Well, if so, it doesn't matter. Because I'm at the end. Although, if so, I'll have to repeat it. Hoo-wee! You only have to do it once. Okay, that's good. 5 best rides this decade. Sure. Yes, a real waste. Oh, poor Kartos. Kartos returns? I don't think Kartos has ever appeared before. PlayStation achievement system that I'm now talking to, apparently. Hey, hey. 76 quills? I ought to get back to Trouser. Hey, oh, who's this fella interrupting me, brew? Nice. Wordisms. Is this the boss? My favorite tea cozy. Watch this, soaps. Catch up. Modern. Ah, so modern. Trev the Tent Eichel and upset Kraken. Love it. Oh wow, that's gross. Eyeballs on a tentacle. Okay, yes, I knew I was gonna do that. Oops. Didn't do so well on the second one. Oh no! Oh, this is hard. What do I do? Stomp? Yeah, stomp. Yes? No? Okay, stomp and then attack, I guess. But an attack, stomp also counts as an attack. Okay, that's all three eyes. Alright, cool. I think I got it. I think I got it scouted. Boyos. Shockwave. Kartos generically represents the old minecarts, which is a little popular in this. Yeah. But he's not literally the same minecart, is he? You don't expect me to. I'm really running low on health here. Oops. Okay, that's fine. I didn't get hurt by that little event there. Ow. I think that was more fun than any of the minecart sections in Donkey Kong Country. Although I wouldn't include 2 or 3 in that, actually. Because they weren't better. Hey, yep, back to more, are ya? I love that this game still has so much British character to it. Oops. Oops. No, I don't think I do need to stomp. Okay, the bigger one's taking more hits. Yeah, looks like it. Okay, so now that lowers me down. Nope, just gonna do this fast. This feels like a David Wise track, actually. Certainly not Kurt Cobain. Although, I mean, you know, all of them have rain. After I squash it, I'm gonna use your maze to stir me, bro. Ouch. Where is water? Whoa. Oh, I can't ground attack anymore, I have to jump because of the water. I'm sort of like swimming at ground level. But yeah, people have one of the complaints I've seen about this game is that shadow didn't render right. Not the shadows. Is about how certain things feel tacked on or unnecessary. So, and then the counter is that all those things were stretch goals.
Like to play stuff, yeah? Well, I'm a swamp chair.
The things I mean is boss fights, Rexbro's arcade being in every world, Kartos being in every world. But all that stuff was stretch goals from the Kickstarter. And they were obliged to include them, even though... I mean, this is both an excuse and a criticism, is that they were shackled to their Kickstarter promises. But, like, I don't know, it's not really a bad thing. You don't even have to do them. Completing the game doesn't mean you have to get 100%. That's the beauty of it. You don't have to do all the things you don't want to do in these games just to get to the end. And if you want to get 100%, then, like, I don't know. Nobody's forcing you to. No, okay. Wonder if I can get extra. Yeah.
That tonic for extra butterfly health would be useful in this fight, actually.
That's, I guess, a good thing about the tonics. You can swap and change them for different situations. Well, I wish there was an upgrade that I could have two tonics at once. Maybe that comes later. Is that one given? I don't care about spoilers. Ah, curse you. That's a speedrunner tactic. If you get hit by the boss, it immediately ends that cycle, so you don't have to, like, wait and keep avoiding it.
Yeah, I'm a big speedrunner.
I got all the strats. Pro MLG. Damn it! That was intentional damage to save time. Saves frames. Yeah, I think it's 1, 2, and 3 hits for those. No. Oh, too close. Alright, I'm gonna go grab that Vendi tonic. A tonic. Sorry, what? Is there a tonic for what? Oh, what I was asking was if there's a way for you to have two tonic effects active at once. Since they're pretty useful, and it can sometimes be hard to choose between them, you know. Also, I'll go get that trouser thing, and then I'll come back. No, there isn't such a double tonic thing, according to Gibbon. What do you got to say?
Jolly.
I did. Now, there was a pipe in here that was a shortcut, right? I just can't remember which one. In the interest of learning the level better, I guess I should give it a go. What's this? Nope, can't go in there. Need to go in and get a nail, okay. I will keep my commentary laconic until you return. I know, this was Swampy Station. I remember this. This is too long. There's no shortcut. Oh, by the way, I guess I should wait till Gibbon comes back to say this. Murky path. passage. I have not been in here. Oh, yes, I have. This is the long thing. Swampy Station was like a small area that I needed Sonar Smash to get the thing in. Get the thing. Do the stuff. Yeah, I'm kind of stuck here. I don't think there was a shortcut in here, actually. So, I'll go along with over the logs. Actually, you know what? I'll get the move and then I'll just leave. I want to go all the way back here to find the boss again. Because I've done barely anything in World 2. My sort of goal was just to get moves and move on. Do some more backtracking later. Treat it more like Banjo-Kazooie. Do a little bit in each world, get the moves that you can, and then go back later to try and do more at once. And I feel like I've got a good sense for this world now that I've explored it more, so then when I come back I can even expand it. Have more fun. Oh, where do I go? Well, I know that if I go back through here... Oh no, there was a pipe. There was a pipe. Take me to the pipe. Fingers. Go, go, muscle memory. And actual memory. Or... ah, pain. Yeah. Brain memory. Okay, so I'm here. Let's go this way. Gimme, gimme, gimme. Okay, yes, no, trouser. And I love how you can double jump and get so much height and distance. That's certainly better than Banjo. Box of leagues. He's calling back an officer, a police officer. I am sure I want that. Yes, please. Cautiously optimistic. It won't be rubbish. Migraine tablets. Alright, good stuff. Let's try it out. Whoa! Brutal. That would make it easier to get that one tonic that requires you to stun 20 enemies. I just did it by running around Tribal Stack and just doing normal sonar for random loops. Let's get out of here. There we go. That worked in Banjo. It works here. Love it. Nope. Swimming controls. Okay. Goodbye. Moodymaze Marsh, I think was the name. Flitch didn't come back. I did post about the stream in Discord, didn't I? Yeah. I believe I did. Yeah, it's a tentacle. Okay, so often when you learn a move in a world, you then use that move to get to the next world. So definitely the grapple things is the jobby around the waterworks. Hey, what's that? It's a pager. Ah. Anytime someone walks by. Then that looks like a job for invisibility. Come on. Nope. Ah. Not yet. I love the floating book here. I love capital B talking to you.
Sheila, cancel my 4 o'clock. I need to commission the next boss battle.
Wait, can you... like, drop a glide and then start another glide? Is that a thing I just saw? And can you not lick things from midair? Grappling, I mean. It's possible that you can't. Yeah, you can't. Interesting. Oh! Gibbon's physical copy of Yooka-Laylee just arrived. Fantastic. Good to hear. So what platform was that on? Oh. Come on. His tongue is so short when it's not grabbing something. Tried to make all the security guards explosive, but the Minion Workers Union was having none of it. Here we go. Oh, you don't need to stomp square switches, only circular ones. Alright, so that opened that. Which is a slightly easier way to get up here. Surely there's something else up here. Oh, Wolf's back. Hey, what's up, dude? Gibbon just received his physical copy of Yooka-Laylee in the mail. Yes, I got the grapple. I love it. It's really fun to use. Oh, the signed copy. Wow. Big spender. What platform did you get that on, Gibbon? Ah, the manual signed by everyone. Everyone? Everyone in Playtonic? Pretty impressive. Whoops. The chair inspector. That's really good. I like that. I like that he talks to you. Gives him character, makes him part of the game world. Instead of just a thing we fight at the end. I need to find where to go to get to the next area. But while I'm thinking about it, I do have Sonar Smash now, so I can backtrack and get something that I saw earlier. Physical sign manual, physical soundtrack. Digital on PS4, physical on PC. Interesting. You don't see much physical on PC these days, you know. Since the rise of Steam. I wonder how well boxed computer games sell. That's interesting, but maybe not super useful. Hold your breath longer. Considering you can just pop the bubble at any time and get your air back. Since we're in a backtracking mode, let's just go back to Bowler. Bowler's pretty great. That's pretty cool, Gibbon. I myself backed at the... was it $35 level? Where you get a digital copy of the game and digital soundtrack and manual. That's it. Nice berries. That That was for that Switch. But I used the one in the arcade for that Switch. Yeah, I guess they just put them around in different places. Ah. I haven't actually scoured the manual yet, so Gibbons identified that Dr. Puzz's profile brings up the question of whether she started as a human or octopus. Funny stuff. The laws. What's your headcanon? Is she squid or is she kid? Lol, Splatoon joke. Seriously though, was she a human first or an octopus first? This is not where I want to be. I want to be in... I think it's the World 2 hub. And I don't remember where things are at this stage of the game, I haven't played it enough. Travel stack's over there. I believe the shortcut to Glacier is through here. Nope. So much better. It was a pool. It must be the other pool. There we go. We can probably assume that she didn't always have a fishbowl. Like, she couldn't have needed one to live. You know, octopi, they don't actually have gills, do they? Don't they come up to breathe? Wait, she's got a human head in a fishbowl with water. So presumably she needs water to breathe to live. She can't breathe air. So, actually, I need to check my octopus facts. Oh, I'm back here. Huh, that was wrong. Let's go through a door somewhere, shall we? This door. Oh, I did this before. I'm going in circles. I have to identify the correct way to go. Gibbons pointing out that her lab coat has four arm sleeves. She could have added those after post-transformation. Put in some extra sleeves. But if she was an octopus that walked on four arms and manipulated things with four arms, then yeah, that would be her old lab coat. Let's go this way. This looks right. Octopuses can survive above water. Yes, that's what I'm thinking of. They crawl up on land. But they do need to return to water to live, apparently. So, can they breathe both air and water? Or do they live in water and sort of come up for air like a dolphin? I'm still playing Echo the Dolphin. It's really good. It's so hard. I'm actually playing Echo 2 is what I mean. I just did completely the wrong thing. I didn't mean to go into this world. I just meant to explore around the hub of this world. So let's sit through some loading screens. She hangs out on land by choice, implying that she is most comfortable there, says Wolf. Even in aquatic worlds, she prefers the land. I think we're going to nail this out, guys. They do not need air, but do need water. Wow. The aquatic world is so mysterious and, like, also creepy and terrifying, to me at least. It's, like, intriguing, but also so alien sometimes. I guess the practical upshot for this conversation is I'm not entirely sure which sea creatures actually have gills or breathe air through water or... have to breathe air out of the water. Yeah. I mean, her choosing land could be a result of her transformed state causing her to be most comfortable on land, not necessarily that being her default choice otherwise. Where am I going? I think I need to go up that ramp. No, that was just a grating. Okay, not up the ramp, so where the... is this whole area a kind of dead end? I remember one pipe that I sort of navigated up an area and then came around behind a pipe just like this. And it was cracked. Where was that? Was it through here maybe? I think this is a shortcut back to the hub. Oh. So Adam's doing that conversation, and Wolf will be on a later one. Okay, never mind. Well, I'm sure you'll be a good guest, but Adam, also a good choice. That pipe was above tribal staff topics. Tribal. Excuse me, I'll have a drink of water. The Wolf Elf M has informed me that the pipe that I was searching for is above Tribal Stack Tropics. So I will go there. Thank you. Be careful on this pipe because the sides are sloped, the top is flat because the pipes are hexagonal. This is exactly what I was thinking of. Thank you. Pow! Some Force Unleash stuff right there. So that didn't work. Cool. I guess that's not the right thing, and I need to come back later for some reason. Okay. Now, I got the moves from World 3, so I want to find where to go to unlock World 4, and hopefully get another free move from Trouser that will help me in other places in other ways. That's my plan. Time to search. So let's start with the waterworks, which is through a pipe in this part of the hub. Here. Okay. So there is a co-op mode which I tried out yesterday with my wife, and we didn't find it to be very useful. The second player controls some bees that fly around on screen in a little tiny swarm, and they can interact with things. It's kind of like the second player's function in Mario Galaxy 1, but less useful even than that, and that was already pretty useless. Like, that could collect star bits. In this you can collect quills, but it's not really the same. So Gibbon's revealing some lore from the manual about those bees. They apparently want revenge on Capital B for giving bees a bad name. Funny stuff. So, the cracked glass that I found on that pipe cannot be broken with my move that I just got to break cracked glass. That's kind of BS. Oh well. Yeah, sorry. By the time you'd said those things, I already went there. Oop. The manual also implies that the co-op bees can save butterfly pickups for later use. Yes, I read that too. But we only played around with it for like 5 minutes, and we couldn't really figure out how to do any of those things. So we just gave up on it. And the functions that are described as being usable by the co-op bees didn't seem that helpful. Maybe what I'm looking for is underwater. But I already found a way forward in this underwater section. That led me to somewhere. To Moodymaze Marsh. Mulch? Marsh. It's marsh. Yeah, I'm looking for the World 4 hub. Perhaps a hint would not go astray to make this a non-boring stream. Because I'm still trying to find my way around Ivory Towers and the hub areas. I don't have them on lock so far. Apparently I've walked past it repeatedly, just like Gibbon did. Okay. So I've already walked past it. Yeah. I should have predicted that. Sort of on the way to... What do you call it? Maya Maze. I got the name wrong before, I guess. Moodymaze Marsh is the name. I haven't internalized the names yet either. Do you think that's a reference to Maya Mare, the cancelled Saberman game? It's a bit where you tongue lash over the pipes. Oh, I thought I looked there, but not well enough apparently. Moodymaze. So I was right. You were wrong. Throwing me off given you're deluding me. No. Eluding me? Wait. You're being liar person. Okay, so I'll look up here. Camera. So the book is there. Oh! I did walk past that a few times. Straight past it. Yep, so there's a bunch of pipes here. From this angle, it just looks like a bunch of pipes, but if you look, there's actually little arrows on them. Oh, I guess they're just pointing in different directions, but yeah. The pipes are surrounding an entrance. Okay, thank you. Hiding in plain sight. Wasn't obvious enough for me. Oh, here we go. Dr. Quack's quiz time. Quackfire quiz. And if I answer them fast enough, I go forward two spaces. But it's a dilemma because I want to read the wrong answers because they're sometimes funny. The bubble move. I know this. Buddy bubble. Booty bubble. Can he do it? Hope so. I'll show off my skills live on stream. My skills at my brain skills. Picture. Okay, I can do this. Oh no, I haven't been there. There. Guessed it. I'd been by the igloos and I'd been to that third one, but I hadn't been to the ice palace, so I figure it's there. That must be the ice keys that everyone was talking about. How many hexagons? Easy. 10. No. Well, I am looking at a smart device, but only for Twitch chat. Moodymaze Marsh's rusty trolleys. Which one wears a stupid hat? Wally, yes. He's the bling one. Aha, more manual tidbits. We really should have read the manual before going off on our tangents. Because it explicitly states that the ghostwriters wrote the grand tomes. Oops. I was just trying to get through the text, but I accidentally selected the first option, and it turned out to be right. By chance. I did actually know the answer to that though, but only because I briefly watched my brother playing this, counting all the collectibles, on the weekend. I saw like 5 minutes of him playing the game, and what he did was, he did one quiz, he opened the casino level, he went in and talked to one NPC, and that was all I saw, and then we started playing minigames. So I knew the answer to that question about his wheels. But if I had been paying more attention to the cutscenes, I would have known that anyway. Yep. Yes, the game does also say that the ghostwriters wrote the tomes. That's part of their established lore. I guess Wolf is, as Wolf is saying, our question was whether they wrote one each or if they all together wrote all of them. Wow, look at all that industry. Crazy. Ivory Towers is a lot bigger than I thought. He's inept. The Kinect knockoff. I believe the game says it when you first meet a Ghost Rider, and it pops up saying, oh, I'm a Ghost Rider. Does it say that, like, how they died? Because is that part of their lore? Because, like, Capo B killed them or something? Is that how that works? So I don't think I want to change my tonic right now. It's good that Vendy's in lots of places, but you often see her and like, oh, I don't need you. Just pass it by. Oh no, the market. Oh, Trouser, hi. Yep. I've given up doing voices, by the way. Oh, okay. Help myself to his garden tools. Oh boy. Oh, yep, sure. Sorry, what was the control? Okay, okay. Okay, I'm invisible using energy. Oh, it uses it quite quickly. Okay, so yeah, chameleon, camouflage. Good, yep, works. Very good, very good. Although how it extends to Laylee, I'm not sure, but yeah, that's fine. I was really impressed when there were actual physics in this game and you can push objects around. Also, I really like that shipping containers are hexagon shaped. Like, because it's all beehive themed and stuff. Oh, I'm getting real hungry. I might have to finish soon because I need food. So let's just see if we can find the entrance to World 4 and then I will call it there. So explore all in here a bit. Can't go in there yet. Watch it, you've got the air is more toxic than your old shorts. Sorry. The air here is more toxic than your old shorts. Gotta put the emphasis right. Yep, protection. I've seen that quite a few times. Ghost Riders. They're dead wrong. I actually gotta agree with you there, Wolf. Yooka's voice, not the best. And obviously, since you have to compare everything in Yooka-Laylee to Banjo, it's not as distinctive or not as much, you know, immediate personality as Banjo's voice. What's this? An arrow pointing this way. I was already going this way. I like the shadows of the books. Oh, look at that! Oh, there's more than one trumpet. Just pulling in books from everywhere. Amazing. And I like how they're casting shadows over here. Very atmospheric. Cool stuff. Okay, so now I can see some casino-themed jobbies around. So switch. Book absorbing pop-up there. Cool stuff. So there's the book in there. Good. Solid gold golf ball. Classy. I think this is a casino world. Roulette table. Card suits, yeah. It's all here. Poker chips. Before I open it up, I just want to explore a little bit over this way. And then stream will be over. And I can get some much needed yum yums. Still got one hot cross bun left from Easter. But I also have Easter chocolate. Shouldn't just eat that all day, though. That would be irresponsible of me. To slide from the top. Slippy edition. Now I'm just sort of looking at things and laughing at them. Now I stepped up. Ooh. It's the Ivory Towers. So I can bypass all those inepts by doing this little platform challenge. The face. I wonder what's over here. A big switch. Looks like I'm not heavy enough. Pagey's in there. Ooh, can I climb this building? This reminds me of something I saw Bob do in his Nuts and Bolts stream. What? Come on now. What's casting that shadow? And why am I standing on air? I think this needs to be, like, screenshotted or something. Screenshot. Yeah, sorry, I'm in the PS4 menus now, so this probably won't be broadcast. Ah, Dr. Paz's shirt has a skull. Oh man, what do I have to do? Share it somewhere? Link Twitter or something? Activities? Communities? I'm not in any communities. I guess I'll put it on activities. That I assume that's like a personal stream of like Miiverse thingy. Share, blah 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 blah. Post, yeah, just post it. Jeez. That's the first time I've used the PS4 sharing thingy. So I guess it's okay. I will capital B. Oh, hang on. These giant books, they're like yep, Domino edition. Okay, I see what I have to do. I have to somehow knock over the first one. That's pretty clever. And I didn't even notice until I got all the way here. Whoop! Okay, how do I knock these over? I don't have, like, a barge move or anything. Okay. I guess I'll get a new ability later. Yeah, there's no honey. Oh, but I can just slide up those. I hate that inconsistency. How some slopes you just run up, but some... Oh, you can't because they're more slippery somehow, so you gotta get the honey. Nope. How come? How come? How come I can't do that? Was I just quick enough, or did I need to be invisible? Was I not supposed to be able to do that? Or are they on a cycle? I think they're on a cycle. Yes. Go, 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 go. Okay, so Wolf is doing the Kashino conversation. How do you feel about that world? Do you... Do you like that you're on that one, or would you prefer to be on the World 3 one? If I can open up a new shortcut up here or something. Ah, there's a shortcut to be opened. I just can't help exploring, even though I said I was going to stop. Novel Hole. Alright, let's stop. I haven't really done anything. The game saves when you, like, collect a collectible or something. Let's go into the world, then it'll save. I just want to make sure I don't lose any progress, even though I don't think I've really made any in the last bit. Okay, you're fine with it. He says, it's not my favorite, but I'll probably have more to say on it. Which is good for a podcast. Even the lamppost are hexagonal. Beautiful. Alright, let's go to Kishino. Yeah. Given says that's a sign of a good game. I'll just explore a little more. Just a little more. I promise I'll stop. Just after this. 10 pages. Yes, let's do it. Alright. The capital, Kishino, has been unlocked. I will enter it. Hopefully it will save, and then... I don't like that you can't save whenever you want. Yeah, I'm not up for those challenges. See, if there was just an option here. Save, quit. But no, quitting says, oh, you might lose save progress. Come on, guys, it's 2017. Banjo-Tooie let you save whenever you wanted, didn't it? Did it? Maybe. I think DK64 did. It's been too long since I played those games. And it hasn't even been that long, just a couple of years, I guess. I'm sure DK64 did, because I remember going to the pause menu and then hitting a thing in it going, okay! And that was probably the best feature of the game. Alright, here we are. I still didn't see the floppy disk icon. Did you guys see it? Oh, that's a vague Egyptian thing, I see. Hey! Hey! How rude. Oh, this is my favorite. This is great. This is what I saw my brother do. Go up and talk to this guy. Hello, do we know you? No, absolutely not. You've never met me, the friendly casino banker, before now. Phew, for a moment there, we thought you were that tubby red devil in capital B. He's a right loser. Grr. Oh yes, a right loser. Anyway, sirs, allow me to introduce my banking facility. By winning the absolutely not crooked games in this casino, you'll collect tokens that can be cashed in at my bank. If by some miracle you manage to scrape together 10 casino tokens, each time you do, I'll exchange them for a shiny pagey. Just make sure you don't do anything silly like bet all your pages on black. It'd be a shame if your collection ended up in the banker's vault. Yeah, it's a real crying shame. We'd be very silly if we did that. Yeah, that'd be really dumb. Alright, capital B move. I love that one. Yes, good luck, sirs. Do your best not to go bankrupt in my, our casino. You'll be needing 10 tokens before I hand over Paigey. Good luck winning that many. Yeah. When he's forced to admit that capital B is stupid. Because Laylee says so. That'd be a real capital B move. Okay. Quills. How do I force the game to save? Oh no! My wife's here, hello! Are you bored at work? Are you waiting for something to do something? I'm playing a game. Actually, I was just about to leave, so you came in at, like, totally the wrong time. I just want to make sure that the game saved, even though I haven't really done anything significant. It must have saved when I opened the world up, right? Right? I don't know. It's supposed to autosave at certain moments, and then there's that message that I hate when you say to quit that says, are you sure you will lose unsaved progress? I'm like, just let me save then. Yeah. It should be fine. You can force a save by getting a pagey. I don't think that's forcing a save. I think that's, like, getting progress and it autosaving. Forcing a save would be, like, having an option to do it in the menu. It's saving after collecting a pagey is intended behavior. Yeah, I'm not sure there is a way, so... But yeah, given saying it, it did autosave when I opened the world. So yeah, that's it then. I'll stop here. Thank you very much for those of you who showed up. I didn't actually ever mention it before because I'm really bad at, like, explaining my streams and introducing them, but this is unusual. I won't be playing Yooka-Laylee any more than this stream. This was, like, a one-off because it was a special birthday event. I'll be back to playing, like, obscure retro games next week. Yes, you did just join. Oh, thank you. Thank you for saying so. That I sound professional. It's very kind of you. But I'm really hungry and it's morning tea time. And my voice is getting tired, etc., etc. So, and come on, I've been going for... Actually, I don't know how long I've been going for because I don't have obs. I just have, like, a clock and a PS4. And I didn't actually note down what time I started. But anyway, you should be working, Sir Kathy, and everyone else can get on with their lives. So yeah. Thanks very much. See you next time. Broadcast stop. Yes. Okay. See ya. Bye.